Well, that's a different kind of thing. And now for something completely different. In stark contrast to that last piece, we would like to take you back in time. To a very, 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 bloody, very, very, very old song. And this tour is almost the 10th anniversary of this song. So that shows how old it is. And we thought we'd dust off all our old 12-string guitars and dust off all our old storybooks and stories and bring to you the populace of New York in general a song of ours which has many, 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 many loud bits and many, many quiet bits. Loud bits, quiet bits. I think we've almost got it. Loud bits! Quiet bits! Are you sitting comfortably? Well, I shall begin. This then, everybody, is the story of two young virgins, Romeo and Juliet. Now Romeo, this hand over here, was 16 years old and he was very, very partial to sexual stimulation. Juliet, this hand over here, she was also 16 years old and very, very large in the upper regions. And one day, Romeo, feeling a little like a bit of sexual stimulation, decided to telephone Juliet and ask her out to a drive-in movie. And we all know what happens at drive-in movies, and Juliet, being very large in her upper regions, and herself feeling a little bit partial to sexual stimulation, decided to accept the kind invitation and said yes. And Romeo, before very long, whizzed round in his father's car and opened the door, and Juliet hopped in and they whizzed off down the road to the drive-in. Suddenly, in the back of the car, the movie started and Romeo started to fondle Juliet's upper regions. These upper regions proved too large for one of Romeo's hands. And so he tore off Juliet's dress and removed carefully her stockings. And finally took off her brassiere. Onto an even dirtier page 3. Well, quickly Romeo undid his trousers and took them off. Poor old Romeo, he had to do this himself, you see, because at this time, Juliet was in fact tied up to the steering wheel. Now Romeo, who had by this time had forgotten completely about the film, he approached Juliet, and Juliet, from her crouched position by the steering wheel, said, "No, no, Romeo, don't come near me with that thing. I won't, I won't." And Romeo, surprised by this last remark, because he was very highly aroused at this time, he said, "Juliet, you cannot leave me like this." And Juliet again took a long, long look at that thing and said, "No, no, Romeo, I won't, because you see, I've just remembered that I think supper is ready." Walking across the sitting room, a tiny, tiny evil's in our heart. Sitting beside you, I look into your eyes as the sound of motor cars, they fade in our nighttime. That's where I saw your face change. It don't seem quite right. And it's shrouded head, lean across the room slowly. The Seventh walks in front, the cross held high in hand, and it's, hey man, your supper's waiting for you. Such a long, long time, hasn't it? social security took